Hey Crazy Folders, I'm back from Lyon and today I want to show you The Hummingbird by Christopher Rundell. I have made two variations of this model, which I will teach you in this video. If you like to see the original video, you can find it here. What you need is a square of paper with two colors. In this video I will use 20 cm kami, but if you like to shape it beautiful at the end, you should use kind of tissue foil or papers you can shape with water or MC glue at the end. I will fold a green hummingbird with white beak, so the color of the beak is facing up. Let's start. First of all, we fold the paper in half. Open it again and fold in the other direction. Open this fold, turn the paper over and fold the diagonals. Open again and recollapse the preliminary base. Now we like to petal fold on this side. Like this. Fold this part down and fold the tip to this point, to the line. Crease firmly and open it again. Now we have to sink this tip. So open the paper. And you have to change all this square folds into mountain folds. And the diagonals will be valley folds. Like this. Turn the model over and we make a valley fold on the first layer between these two points. Open again and fold these two points to the middle point. And open again. Now we have to reverse fold these two parts. So open the paper and push it in on the other side. Open and push in. Like this. Now we lift up this flap and fold it to the right, like this. And also fold this valley fold to the left. Now we fold this edge to the middle crease and crease firmly. Do it on the other side. And open both again. Now we have to sync these two parts. We will start with the left part. So open the paper and you have a rectangle here. So push out a bit and change all the four folds into mountain folds, as we did before with the tip of the model. So then push this together and also on the other side. Like this. Now we open the right part. Again, push it out a bit. Change all four folds into mountain folds. And push it together. Like this. It should look like this. Now we open this layer a bit and we fold this edge not to this edge but a bit with a bit space, so that there is a little green strip of paper like this. And now make a valley fold from this point where this crease line ends to this point. And then close the model. So we like to have a color change here. Do it on the other side. Turn the model over again and fold this flap up. Oh. Now we have to fold this edge to the middle crease. Like this. And do it on the other side. Now turn it over again. Next, we have this edge here and this small tip, and on this line we fold down the top part. And we fold up it again with a valley fold between these two parts, between this point and this point. So, like this. Rotate the model and we have to fold this edge to the middle crease while squashing this part. So open this pocket a bit and squash it while folding the edge to the middle crease, like this, and do it on the other side. Like this. Turn the model over again. And we like a color change on the beak. So, open all the layers here in the middle and swivel them to the side. So, it will swivel inside here. And push it flat. Do it on the other side. Like this. Now you can fold the sides to the back side with a mountain fold. So you can turn it over and it's easier to fold like this. You fold behind this squash fold. And we have the color change. Now we fold the model in half. Like this. And we lift up the wing a bit, and we have a mountain fold here. So reverse fold this part, but not completely. So if we have it like this, we have to fold this middle mountain fold to this mountain fold. Like this, and also this mountain fold to this edge. Like this. So it should look like this. Now I have these two versions, and first of all I will show you this version. They are quite the same, so you will see soon. So open this wing and then make a small valley fold like this to this edge. And push this part over the wing and push this together. So the wing will be 3D and the belly will open a bit. Like this. And do it on the other side. You can slide it a bit like this, and so now it's better to have tissue foil or something like this, and the wing will stay in position better. You can curve the beak a bit, and you can also fold it in half from the sides from both sides. It's also easier with tissue foil or something like this, and you can curve it a bit. Also, you can open the head and make a bow like this, so it's a bit more three-dimensional. But this is the first version. If you have better paper, it will stay like this. For the second version, I will use this one. So we fold quite similar like at the first version, but the valley fold will go until something like this. So it's much wider. And when we have this, we will open it again and push from the inside of the model, push this point to the side, and then we fold. So we have a three-dimensional belly. And we fold the wing a bit to the side, like this. Do it on the other side. So it's a long valley fold and a small mountain fold. Like this. Then open again. Push out this point and refold. And then make a little valley fold to lock this. So we can push it in a nice shape. And for sure you can leave it like this, but in my opinion it looks nicer if the tail is a bit more down. So what we are going to do is we have this valley and mountain folds here, and we like to add a new crimp fold. So we open this part a bit and we push this a bit in. That far we like it. So you can look by yourself. If you like it like this, or like this, or like this. And then make a new pleat fold. Something like this. And you can use a tool like this to go in and push the head a bit more three-dimensional. So there's a valley fold here, and we like to push out that a bit. You can also use your finger. So, and if you have this, the model is finished. Looks like this. I think it's a beautiful model to vary. So you can also vary on the head to make a crimp here, to get it a bit more down, or working on the tail. So I think there are many other ways to shape this hummingbird, and that is why I really like this model. It's very simple. You can fold it very fast, and it's very beautiful. So, hope you enjoyed the video. Check out the channel by Christopher, and see you in the next video. I think the next video will be a video about the Ultimate Origami Convention in Lyon.